Hello everyone and welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today will be a small beginner tutorial on how to tune the violin. Tuning the violin is a very big topic. Today I will just cover the basics. Before you start attempting to tune your instrument, you should know what notes the strings are. So we start from the bottom string. The lowest is the G. The second lowest is the D, and then the A, and then the E string. Write that down or have it in your mind when you tune your strings. Secondly, I would suggest to you that you begin tuning the violin at first, not like a professional playing two strings at one time, but to compare each string individually with a piano or with an electric tuning device. There are three main options when it comes to tuning the violin with an electric external device. First is the metronome. Most electrical metronomes have the option of generating a sound like this. And they generate this sound on a specific pitch. And you can choose this pitch in the menu of the metronome. You can adjust here the note and also the frequency of the note you want to hear and compare with. Most violinists use a metronome for tuning the A and comparing it to the open A string, for tuning the A string and tune the other strings by ear. The second device, which is very helpful for violinists or every musician, this is a chromatic tuner. This device looks very similar to this one, but the display is reactionary. That means when you sing a note or play a note, I will now play the note of the metronome. It recognizes the pitch and shows you if you are in the correct pitch. When I now change the pitch, now I played here a too high A and it showed me this red light on the right side, and that means that the note is too high. When you compare to a violin string, you of course want the pitch to be exactly in the green light and in the middle. And also you want here to show up the correct name of the string. For example, now there's a G sharp. Instead of purchasing a dedicated device as a metronome or as an electric tuner, you can just go to the App Store and type in chromatic tuner. And usually the first app you can get will be something useful. So download it and use it as you use a chromatic tuner. Let me show you now how we actually change the pitch of the strings on the violin. When it comes to adjusting the pitch of the strings, we have two very different possibilities to do that. I will name you first the one which you should not do in the beginning when you are not really familiar with the instrument, because it is very likely that you break a string when you use the pegs right here at the peg box. Those are for tuning the strings, of course, but they react very directly and you have to be very careful and not turn them too far and always go first below the pitch and then up the pitch you want to go when you use them or when you need to use them. But I will talk more about the pegs in the video about the advanced techniques of tuning an instrument. For now, I will show you how those so-called fine tuners function. The fine tuners are actually made for the sole purpose that you can adjust the pitch in a much more subtle manner. Let me very quickly explain to you how the fine tuners work. How a fine tuner works is actually quite sophisticated. At first, let us start with this. This is the tailpiece. Now we have our fine tuner in green sitting on top of it with the screw going through the tailpiece. The fine tuner is actually an L-formed piece of metal like this, and it's attached here and like this. In this L-formed piece, there is the violin string going this way. When we now adjust this screw, it's actually quite a simple screw. So we turn the screw clockwise, we turn it further down into the tailpiece. What will happen then is the screw will go until here, from here until here, and it will make this L-shaped fine tuner go a little bit like this. And therefore, we'll pull the string a little bit back and the string tension gets higher, and that's why the pitch gets higher. If we loosen the fine tuner, this end gets smaller and therefore not pushing this L-shaped part of the fine tuner so much down. Therefore, there is less tension on the string now. So now you know that when you turn a fine tuner clockwise, the string pitch will get higher. When you turn the fine tuner counterclockwise, the string pitch will get lower. Now we have the problem how we bring the string to sound while we are turning this fine tuner. There are, of course, many ways to compare the instrument string to the outside source, but I will show you now the correct way, which you should learn from the beginning, how to compare the string with another instrument and at the same time adjusting the pitch of the string. This way you can hear very easily the differences and the changing of the pitch. What you need for that is a good violin hold. For me, it is very easy to tune my violin with a shoulder rest, and it gets a little bit harder when I don't have my shoulder rest on because I cannot hold my violin just with the head, which I will show you now is needed when you want to turn the fine tuner with your left hand and play the note with your right hand. Hold your violin at the shoulder and at your chin, and now you bring your left hand, which usually plays the notes on the fingerboard, on the inside of the violin, very close to your body and to the fine tuners. Really close, that you will not be in the way where your bow should move. Now what I want you to do is, before you start playing and adjusting the fine tuners, is think about which direction is actually clockwise and which is counterclockwise, and try to remember that, because this movement, and also because it's the left hand, for people who are not lefties, it is sometimes difficult and abstract to understand which way to turn the fine tuner correctly. So when you now have this position and your hand is on the fine tuner, you are able to play the string while you adjust the pitch of the note. I will show you how that sounds. Now the pitch is lower. I will now higher the pitch. In the beginning, try not to be too careful with the fine tuners. You cannot do too much wrong with those, because only then you will hear a significantly changing of the pitch. Of course, when you work with an electric tuning device, or when you want to hit a pitch very, very correctly, you want to make very fine adjustments also at the fine tuners. For example, for the A string, it goes like this. I put this on the A. Make sure there's A right here. And then I play my A string. And now it's the goal to hear the difference. My ears now tell me my string is too high, so I go to the fine tuner and adjust it. You can now tune all your strings in the way I showed you, putting your violin on the shoulder, putting your head on your violin, on the chin rest, going on the inside of the violin to the fine tuner, playing the note and comparing to the outside source. So that it is for now. I just wanted to show you how the fine tuners work, and I wanted to show you how you hold your violin and tune and turn the fine tuners at the same time as you play the notes. In the video where I will show you how professionals tune their violins or advanced players, I will be going more into detail how to tune the violin when you just get an A as a reference, and from there on tuning the D string, the G string and the E string just by ear. And I will give you a little bit of theoretical background and also some tips and tricks how to learn to listen to those intervals between the strings. I hope you enjoyed the video, and most important of all, I hope it was helpful for you. Try to tune your instrument as soon as you can. Start learning how the fine tuners work. Start learning how it feels and how you can move your bow smoothly while turning a fine tuner. This all needs some practice, and this practice will help you later when you will tune your instrument in the professional way. Leave the channel a like if you are new to the channel. Subscribe to the channel as well if you want. It helps me a lot if you do all those things. So don't be lazy and stay tuned and have fun tuning your instrument. Bye bye.